appointment, I will now invite Dato' Sri Anwar Ibrahim, Member of Parliament, Chair of Opposition and Pakatan Rakyat Chairman, to deliver his keynote address to the team Egypt at the crossroads.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sudah seminggu sudah tentang Al-Quran bersama kesian. Dalam beberapa pertemuan dalam Al-Quran kita menyaksikan kerusakan dan dianggap dalam kakak sebab itulah rakan-rakan yang ada komitmen yang jelas kepada dalam pertemuan saya di Sanggung Bapak Bini dan Syarat-syarat Musi dan Raih Perubahan dan juga kumpulan yang berkumpul yang melibatkan semua kumpulan oposisi Siri anggota mendengarkan sebagaimana tentang kepada umat sekalian. Jadi sehingga saya meneruskan dan kehadiran rakan-rakan keluarga dalam bahasa Inggris dan secara saya meneruskan sedikit dalam bahasa. Now it seems the meetings here and overseas among committed dedicated Muslims and particular news to express to strong terms and military concerns. This development in Egypt and the turmoil in the Arab world is seen as a major catastrophe for the Ummah in recent times. Every state, from Iraq to Afghanistan, now Syria, Egypt, the next target, possibly Tunisia, and more pronounced Turkey. I'm not a major supporter of this conspirational theories, but this issue must be addressed. In my meeting with Sharash Al-Musi, some representatives from Egypt, Syria, and long sessions with Foreign Minister Davutoglu and Prime Minister Tayyip Erdogan in Istanbul last week. And the general speaking call is for us to take a firm position of stand. We believe in freedom and democracy and human dignity. A coup is a coup. An attempt in the United States and to the exception of Germany in nuanced stance, refusal to acknowledge the coup is the beginning of the problem. You find that because the so-called Islamists are in power, notwithstanding some of the reservations expressed, I mean, some candidates as growing tribute towards the Ashad, but also understand that by the economic conditions in Egypt, I was invited by Sheikh Rashid Al-Musi last year to visit Tunisia, address the parliamentarians, particularly from Nahda, met the cabinet members, briefed by the Central Bank Governor, the Minister of Finance. Then Sheikh Rashid asked me, Anwar, we want your comment. You seem to be too quiet. You are invited here to help and give us ideas. And I said, I have been the Minister of Finance for 8 years, but I don't know how to advise state of economics to stay bankrupt. You can't blame the President of the Tunisian government, democratically elected. The country has been destroyed and plundered by the dictators, blatantly corrupt, and stole billions of dollars a year. And now, in a matter of 6 months at a time, they expected Tunisia to solve all the problems in the world. Sheikh Rashid Al-Musi made this observation. I'm sorry. Sheikh Yusuf Al-Khadawi made this observation. that the destruction of institutions in Egypt. And after most in 1 year, it is expected to resolve all the outstanding problems. I heard a long interview by Tony Blair and Al Jazeera, who tried in no one's fashion to rationalize the coup. Well, this is not an ordinary coup because there is this absurd demand by millions of Egyptians expressing their disgust over the failure of Morsi to undertake meaningful measures. The Morsi is clearly incompetent. See, it's the first time in modern history that you rationalize a coup. Now I say, looking at the policies, pronouncements of Morsi, I may have some personal reservations. What I would consider to be a priority that you don't address. You can't rationalize the coup. And it's just speak by the recent media, the Amnobank media, with the mass demonstrations. Therefore, there is a reasonable coup. Let me mass demonstrations here with recent. Why is there no change? The change can must only take place through legitimate expression of the people. Through fair and free elections. Well, that's the first one. Then Tony Blair was asked the second question. But here there were killings. Thousands were killed. Well, his response is clearly hypocritical, dishonest, and shows so much malice and prejudice just because they happen to be Muslims. Or Islamists, or the Ahwah. He said, what do we have to do? Get to the crux of the matter. Whether the security forces were provoked or not. This is the first time in recent times I hear Western leader, a great proponent of democracy, would utter such rubbish in defense of mass killings. Can we hope? No. It's clearly double standard hypocrisy. Even the United States, I've always said consistently from 2005 in the Doha Forum, this policy of ambivalence. Sometimes you support dictators, sometimes you promote democracy. Where it suits your interest. Our position, Muslims or non-Muslims, in medicine, or for that matter, in the world, must have a consistent, coherent message. Do we support freedom and human dignity? If we do, then whether it is in support of Aung San Suu Kyi, a Buddhist, and we supported her on the premise that she has been victimized, that her right has been denied, and the military junta has no respect for human rights. In the same manner, we deplore the atrocities inflicted on their own ears, and are the Muslims. Because they reflect a failure to be consistent and coherent. As people ask, why do you support such an effect? I've always said, Muslim parties, including Pas or Cardinal or all others, is irrespective whether it is a wonder of plight of the non-Muslims. We must be unequivocal in our co the man that justice must be given. And the same here. Now we find in the Muslim world, we expect the same expression. That's why I have no qualms. Okay, we should go hang this here with our friends in the media to express the same. And I'm very pleased that this yes, participants and contribute to the call. This will by itself show that us, Kalilan, if we here simply follow the mission, defense of rights of those abused, then the unknown and leadership in the unknown begins. Now, why did I mention this later on? The two issues raised. Firstly, that we must understand that this is a major catastrophe of the world. Yes, Egypt is the focus of attention. And today, the deliberations in the United States on Syria. But prior to this, Afghanistan, Iraq has been virtually destroyed. And I don't believe this is the end. That is why we expect leaders to propose a message, a strong message. There is a deficit in the woman, in the leadership. Only time the governance, as we said, I mean, of course, they criticize me because I happen to support my friend. It's not really a friendship. I had hours of sessions with him on this issue. And he speaks passionately. And I am equally, as many of you, concerned about his personal welfare and continuing the target. You know what was his response? Very emotional as a brother. He said, I'm the Prime Minister of the last 10 years. A great country with a great history. What do you expect me to do? To remain silent like many of the other Arab and Muslim leaders? When I watch women and children beaten or killed, I'm not fit to be a Prime Minister if I cannot articulate to defend the plight of the poor and those sought. Don't think of Kabila. The alliance of Ibrahim, Skiranya, Orang Ibu, Wanita, dan anak-anak kecil tidak menyentuh langit hati orang lain lagi. Apatah lagi kalau dianggap sebagai tokoh Islam, orang Islam, manusia, rakyat, Muslim bukan Islam, yang diapa-apakan itu tidak menyentuh hatinya. Masih menunggu apa yang Washington kan. Kalau Washington keras, kita pun akan habiskan keras. Kalau Washington agak berlembut, kita pun berlembut. Kalau Washington kata we did flow ataupun we regret, maka Wisma Putra pun we regret. Apa berarti kebebasan kemanusiaan? Dan dalam hal ini, kemanusiaan. Sebab itu, dalam pengalaman dengan Rizal Mesir, saya beritahu Razul, Kasrul Darussalam Rafat dibilang ketika saya suara kalau Allah menganggap ini dan mengharapkan pimpinan negara bisu dan klub tidak berkata kerana tidak ada seorang direction yang jelas dari Washington. Sudah saya memilih itu berkati dan dialog semua. Kemudian dia tanya kepada saya, teruskan dialog dengan Amerika Syarikat.
Zaki, Surat Tumil, Ibrahim. Harus sedikit pun terarah untuk pelaku yang sampai. Tidak bisa bertahan dan hak dari kebebasan kita. Sebab itu saya berulang kali menurut Datuk Sri Naji sebagai pusat di dalam diri. Itu menyatakan pendirian kita. Dan media, terutama media-media UMNO, jangan berjualan seolah-olah emosi atau ini namun ini sebayangkan. Mubarak sahabat, emosi diktator. Yang ini dunia sudah terbalik. Yang hanya melamatkan orang-orang yang berminyakin, tidak faham apa arti kebebasan dan kemanusiaan. So finally, in the discussion with Professor Dayudara, he said, no, I met leaders, had extensive discussions with them. I persuaded him to call SP1, the president you know of Indonesia. Because I know the sentiment in Indonesia is very strong. From Jakarta to Medan, you find mass demonstrations expressing and condemning the coup and atrocities against the people. So I express to Francis Dayudara, because 2 months ago I had a final 1.5 hour session with President S.B. Yudhoyono. Although we talked about the fraudulent process in the elections in Malaysia, but I urged to probably enhance the minister's role internationally, because it's a very difficult time for the people. We expect now to see the minister play. But notwithstanding, I also said to Prime Minister, please do call the Dato' Sri Naji. He smiled before that was a experience. I said no, to the contrary. I mean, we have expressed you should call and urge to stay. But ultimately, our position is the nexus must be. This is why I can commend the effort as me and my people. Because in every way possible, to get people to understand. Because the media seems to agree that he's incompetent. Mostly, incompetent. Last night, Amanusa, the former CEO of the Arabic, the long interview with the BBC, the hard talk, said, we need Egyptians of this custom because the economic policies were flawed. And this comes from Mubarak's ally for 20 years who condemned. Because what happened in Egypt has its ramifications to those who work and more so to First Lady and Azam. And our brothers and sisters of Gaza cannot wait. Because they are living in a ghetto. All sorts of Israel has been blown up. Not by Israel. By the Egyptian forces, can you read it? When I say this, I'm going to say, no, you should put it that way, because you put Israel in somewhere in a positive light. No. Israel is clearly responsible for any of these atrocities. But listen, move. To curb this flow is not easy. So, the consensus that I reached with Ashraf Anousi, Sheikh Al-Bawi, Naya is for the people. That's why you remember the book that we launched and translated at Tawra, Shabiyas. I mean, the people have to rise. Express yourself. In every way possible. I'm glad that
Habib is initiating on the first Al-Hajj and passed away on the sixth Habib and told Mustafa to fully support the rally in the stadium, inshallah. At least we see the people are not receiving way. Our dua and prayers, whatever support we can have. It is a daily calamity in Egypt, in Syria, in Afghanistan. And it's not going to end as we have said soon, but be counted. I'm living for Madeka message this morning, and I think it is consistent with what I have to say. I have earlier, after the coup, written a piece for Al Jazeera English, which is quite distributed, which captures his mood on the attempt against Morsi is actually an attempt to deny the Islamists or political parties their right to be selected as leaders. They attacked Solon Hamas very strongly. Hamas was steadfast, disarmed, and withstood the challenges. Alhamdulillah, they were able to overcome till now. They now targeted Akhwan. And secondly, you accept this anti-democratic force to control the coup. As I said, the catastrophe will be expanded. May Allah help us and stop these atrocities within the Egypt to show that we can be counted. I would appeal here for Malaysia and all Muslims. I'm going to convey Iskandar today, tomorrow, following that tomorrow. The people, non-Muslim friends here to come together, because this is about democracy, freedom, and human dignity. Assalamu alaikum.
الشرطة رجعت مرة تانية تدوس بالأحذية على رؤوس المصريين. هتقبلوا بقكم؟ هتسكتوا عن الحقيقة؟
مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي، أنا مش هرجع إلا بصوتي. مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي، أنا مش هرجع إلا بصوتي.
اضرب غزو ورمه وبارود، حكم العسكر مش هيعود. انا قررت وقلت يا ربي اشرعي لا اما اموت. اقتل كل الكون حوالينا، كل رصاصة بتقوينا. اوعى تفكر ان سلاحك هيجي يوم ويأثر فينا.
مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي، انا مش هرجع الا بصوتي. مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي، انا مش هرجع إلا بصوتي.
لو هتخلي الأرض زلازل مش هستسلم، مش هتنازل.
لو هتخلي الأرض زلازل مش هستسلم، مش هتنازل.
مهما تغدر أو تتفرع عن بكرة، الكرسي بتاعك سائل. اضرب 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 نار، قلد الجزار بشار.
اضرب 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 نار، قلد الجزار بشار.
مهما تقتل فينا سيسي مش هتزدنا غير إصرار.
مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي، انا مش هرجع الا بصوتي. مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي، انا مش هرجع الا بصوتي.
اضرب اضرب بالقناص، اضرب فيا الف رصاص.
اضرب اضرب بالقناص، اضرب فيا الف رصاص.
مش هنفرط في انتخاباتنا، دستور او شورى ورئاسة. مش هيفيدك ضرب رصاص، حكم العسكر بح خلاص.
مش هيفيدك ضرب رصاص، حكم العسكر بح خلاص.
سلميتنا هي سلاحنا وبتهزم مليون قناص.
مش هنرجع، مش هنطاطي،
انا مش هرجع الا بصوتي مش هنرفع مش هنطاطي انا مش هرجع الا بصوتي
ابعت ابعت بلطجية اقتل بدل الواحد مية
ابعت ابعت بلطجية اقتل بدل الواحد مية
مهما تقتل فينا وتموت مش هنفرط في الشرعية اقتل واحد او الفين بدل الشهر اقعد سنتين
اقتل واحد او الفين بدل الشهر اقعد سنتين
ده نفسنا اطول من نفسك واطول من نفس الخاينين
مش هنرفع مش هنطاقي انا مش هرجع إلا بصوتي مش هنرضع مش هنطاقي أنا مش هرجع إلا بصوتي